Hi guys, it's Toddy here from Macumba, and in front of me I have the Google Pixel XL. So this is the larger of the two new phones that Google is releasing at the tail end of 2016. And I believe they both come out on October 20th in the UK. So if you want to see the Pixel unboxing, Chris has already got that one under wraps and it is on our site right now. You can check it out on our YouTube channel too. But this is the larger of the two and I'm going to unbox it for you so you know exactly what to expect when you pick up a Pixel XL yourself. So first and foremost, we've got a new design. The Pixel is kind of like the spiritual successor to the Nexus phones that Google's been releasing over the years, but it is a new brand. They're kind of moving away from the Nexus line. They're kind of going to, they're bringing it in-house as well. Google kind of pushes this as the first phone that is Google inside and out, even though technically I believe it's made by HTC, but they don't even mention that anywhere in any of the marketing materials from what I've seen. But you know, pretty clean box, nothing crazy going on. Just highlights three of the key features here in that it supports the new Google Assistant. This is the first phone with the new Google Assistant integrated, which is like a smarter version of Google Now, effectively. And it's gonna be able to talk to other bots and things like that. It's got Google Cast, which is basically Chromecast support. And you can just, you know, beam your videos and YouTube videos and Netflix films and Google Play Music to various connected devices, such as the Chromecast Ultra, which is also announced alongside the Pixel, and Chromecast Audio, if you have some Chromecast Audio connected speakers in your home. And then Daydream VR is another big part of what makes the Pixel and the Pixel XL stand out. It's the company's new VR platform that they're basically working on, and they also announced the VR headset, the Daydream headset, which went alongside these phones, which is basically going to change the way we interact with VR and hopefully make it way more prevalent in the space, which I think is a great thing personally. So that's everything on the sleeve. This is the 32 gig a month model. There's two models. There's the 32 gig and there's a 128 gig. You can actually see down here in the corner. So the Pixel XL has a 5.5 inch display versus a 5 inch on the standard Pixel. They both come in the same storage SKUs, and then they come in two colors in the UK at launch. The third is coming down the line, but this is the very silver. I think there's quite black. And then there's really blue as well. So the really blue color is coming later, but it is now confirmed to be coming to the UK. And I'm pretty sure that's everything on the box. Oh, nice little Google logo there, just tucked away. And that's kind of it. I've already slipped the thing so you can see. So we have the phone itself first and foremost. And as I said, the Google Assistant is kind of the main selling point of this phone beyond the hardware. And so they mention that right here. So the first thing you know what to do is when you set the phone up is hold that home button down. And yeah, talk to the Google Assistant. So that seems to be it. This is just a nice protective sheath. How does this peel off? I don't want to tear it off if I can avoid doing so. There we go. Carefully pull it out there. So that comes off. And so the phone itself, it feels very lightweight. It's a nice 5.5 inch design, unibody aluminium. That we've seen from the likes of, for instance, the HTC 10, for example, but it does have this glass panel up on the back to kind of, I guess, make it stand out. I'm not sure aesthetically whether it's something I like, but it's distinctive and it's memorable. And also there's a 12 megapixel camera on here with a dual LED flash that Google says is empirically the best camera phone ever made. It's got the highest DxO score of any camera phone, but that doesn't necessarily mean it's the best camera phone. We'll find that out come the full review, but we'll take a look at that further soon. And there's some hardware controls on the side here, power and volume. On this side, you have a nano SIM tray. There's no expandability in this phone. And the front here, I'll power this on whilst we're looking through. If it's got some charge, there we go. It's got an 8 megapixel front facing camera, and then the 5.5 inch screen is, I believe it's a WQHD or, you know, a quad HD AMOLED panel, Super AMOLED panel. So it's, I think it's 2560 by 1440 resolution. Should look really great. It's interesting that the Pixel still rocks a full HD screen, but the XL gets the higher resolution. Oh, nice little new chime startup animation there. So I'll leave that to do its thing. Oh, we still have more animations actually. I'll show you those. There we go. So that's a much faster, nicer animation, introduction animation than I think we've seen from any of the Nexus devices, any phones that kind of debut the first iteration of the next release of Android, which in the case of the Pixel and the Pixel XL is Nougat 7.1. So it's the update on Android 7, which you could get pre-release on the the Nexus 6P and the Nexus 5X, which were last year's Nexus devices. So this little card wallet here just has the Google logo again. Let's go on the tab, pull that open. You've got the SIM tool, and then you've got a whole host of little cards in this nice kind of rounded corner shape. So we've got this fold-out thing get started. So it tells you how to put the SIM card in. And, there's also, which I believe we'll get to in a second, a cable. They have a name for it, but it basically helps you transfer from other devices. They basically show iPhones in all of the marketing material, but they don't say anything about that. So we hope you love your new phone. If you have any questions, we're here for you, so you can get in touch. Google has Pixel has its own dedicated line for customer support, which is nice. And this looks like it's designed to go in any market, this particular piece of bump with these different regional plug things. Also highlights the fingerprint sensor, the volume control, and the power button, and the charging, and then holding for 1 to 3 seconds, I guess, to power it on or power it off. So that is everything for the quick start guide. This is not unlike the Amazon Alexa speaker, showing you some things you can actually ask the Pixel and Pixel XL Google Assistant, which is, as I said, built into the phone. More music, so you get a free demo of Google Play Music. And then after that, it says it's $9.99 a month, which is cool. Thanks for... Interesting. So they're actually pushing you to use social media to talk about the Pixel. I think they're really working hard to get this phone out there. They want it to take on the likes of the iPhone, especially now with the debacle of the Note 7. The Pixel, and especially the XL being the larger of the two, kind of might fill the gap left by Samsung's somewhat combustible phablet. And that's the warranty information there, all the good stuff. And then we have the remainder of the box. So we have a Type-C USB cable, obviously the latest and greatest, so you have a reversible Type-C cable. This nice little latch on here means you can kind of bundle it together more readily when you don't have this tape on it, so that's nice. Looks like a pretty substantial cable too. And then I think this is the, this is the adapter. So you can plug another cable into it and then you can transfer from one phone to another directly. There's no need to either like back up to a cloud or SD card or locally on your computer. You can just do it directly with one phone to another. And that's everything for the left side. The right side, I'm guessing. Okay, so you actually have a second Type-C to Type-C USB. So this is probably the one that connects to that. Or if you are transferring from another Type-C device, which is entirely possible as there are a few out there now, then this is the cable for that. This is also really long. So this, this is the power lead. This is, you can use it for data, but judging by the power brick, it's a Type-C in. So unlike a lot of power bricks where they have a standard size USB here, the Pixel and I'm guessing the Pixel and the Pixel XL both have this Type-C to Type-C USB and it pulls out like that. And the phone, of course, does support fast charging. I believe it's 15 minutes charge gets you 7 hours of use. So that's pretty great too. And the battery inside the Pixel XL, I believe, is a 3,450 milliamp battery. So we'll just jump through some of the startup, setting up the phone. And obviously, if there's anything boring, I will skip that and we'll just jump to the next bit of fun stuff. Okay, so I think I'm through the main boring setup stuff, which is just adding your Google account and verifying all that. So now we have the fingerprint adding section. So I'm just going to tap that. So it's called Pixel Imprint. So they've moved away. I think they use Nexus Imprint with the 6P and the 5X, but they're now rebranding that obviously for the Pixel Imprint. So I'm gonna go with, let's use a pin. I'll just set that up. Okay. So find the sensor on the rear. So it's got this nice little animation here. Hint, it's on the back of the phone. I mean, I wouldn't say you have to spell it out, but maybe you have to spell it out. So there's the fingerprint sensor, so I'm gonna tap that once. And it's already realized that I've pressed it, so I guess I'll just keep pressing that. And it seems like the same setup that you get on all sorts of other phones, especially ones running stock Android or close to it. Fingerprint added, add another, I'll use my left hand as well. I think logically speaking, the index finger seems to be the best one to use when you have a centrally mounted fingerprint sensor on the back. Okay, I'm good with that, done. Back up to Google. I will have that for now, that's great. Location services, help improve. Fine, I will help you improve the services. So here we have the personal assistant. So ask it questions, tell it to do things. It's your own personal Google. To get help from your assistant, say okay Google or touch the hot and hold the home button as we covered earlier when we first took it out of the box. So there are some permissions that you need to let it do, basically give access to your location, etc. I will do that later. But this bit there, it was talking about what's on screen, which is basically Google Now on Tap, which was a feature introduced with Marshmallow last year, I believe. Review settings, All set. I think we're good. So this is the new Android 7.1 UI home screen. So it's actually quite different from stock Android previously, mainly with the way the layout of icons are now circular. For a start, there's this new clean interface. The Google Now screen is now, rather than having the search bar at the top, is this tab that you pull over, and then we have Google Now right there. The clock is nice touch. It faded in. I don't know if you noticed that, and I believe the wallpaper might update, and I think it's just downloading app updates and stuff in the background. But the other thing, you notice there's nice animations there on the home button. These little Google colors pop out each time you press it, which is nice. But you have your main apps here, but then if I drag upwards, then you're straight into the app drawer. So now they've kind of unified the app drawer and the main kind of frequently used apps at the bottom of the screen into a single experience, which I think is really smart. It looks really nice. It feels very natural, and it kind of tidies up the Android interface. Oh, we've got some emails coming in already. Oh, login from Google Pixel XL. What are the chances? So that seems to be everything there. If I press and hold, that looks the same as Android 7 did. We have a multitasking window here, and you can now do split screen with Android 7, so that's nice too, especially on this larger display. And also the notifications pane there, you can get quick settings here, even if I don't have any notifications. And if I swipe down again, then you have, with now a blue accent color. So that's very nice too. So I'm not gonna go into too much detail right now, but we'll be back with the Pixel XL very soon. The last thing I thought I'd show you is the camera experience and just see how quick that is. Because supposedly this is the fastest camera ever, as well as one of the best. I mean, that seems pretty quick. I'll let you know more once I've had a proper test of this. But this is the Google Pixel XL, which, like I said at the start of the video, comes out on October 20th in the UK. I believe the 32GB model is £719 and the 128GB model is £819. And at launch, it's exclusive to Carphone Warehouse, EE, and of course you can buy it directly from Google as well. So it's quite an expensive handset, but it does look like it offers some great hardware. You've got that great 12MP camera on the back, the 8MB on the front. It's got the latest Snapdragon 821 processor in there, quad-core chipset. I think it's one of the only phones on the market right now with a Snapdragon 821, backed up by 4GB of RAM, fast charging, as I said, the fingerprint pixel imprint, I guess it's now called, fingerprint sensor, and of course the Google Assistant. So if you have any questions about this phone right now, just drop us a line down below in the comments, and you can read more on the Pixel and the Pixel XL on recombo.com/mobile. Thanks for watching.